Don't you let anybody ever tell you that eyelashes are hard to put on. I just put my two on in 30 seconds. And 10 minutes ago, they were at home. You know, I came to work half-dressed as usual, but no face at all. And I dashed off and left my eyelashes at home. Good old Dad brought them over for me. So they're still a little wet, a little sticky. So if they start drifting down my face, you'll forgive me. Hello. Thank you for joining me today.
Oh, shit.
Whatever happened? What was that? The milk bottle blew up. April Fool's Day? It really is? No? It was a real thing. Oh, crikey. I can't stand it. What a day. Well, listen, let's go on with our programs, she said bravely after all that. Let's have a look. We'll start from tonight. 7 o'clock, the Partridge Family. 7:30, please, sir. 8:15, Medical Centre, which is always good anyway. What are you doing to me? Oh, dear. 9:15, Riding High, which is the movie. I can't stand it. April Fool's Day is finished. What have you all done? Are you finished? No, I think they've started me too soon and they've set the clocks early. Truly? Really, motel? Oh, I can't stand it. Let's have motel while I recover.
Diamond outside of him that tried to break through. Diamond's now a dummy half. Diamond running with the ball. Bounces straight into his opposing number, Alec Tennant. Diamond looks up to see who gave him the treatment, and Brewers is issuing a warning here to a Manly player. And as you can see, Diamond wasn't too happy about the treatment he was given, and so as he was standing up, I'm afraid his head came in contact with the Manly player that was to mark.
It was Alec Tennant, Ron.
Start the day well with Kinkara. The cup that helps you cope.
Hi, gang. How would you like this great big coloured jigsaw puzzle of Phyllis Diller? We'll swap you the Phyllis Diller jigsaw. Is there anybody in there for news? Where's Auto Q? Come on, fellas. Right.
Good evening. Meanwhile, on the roads and the stage death toll, did I... Two lines. Give us two lines, please.
Oh, Brian.
Could you give me two lines?
Brian!
Jesus Christ, will you give me two lines, please? This next story coming up will be a read, love. This will be a read. Mary Jane Boyd, and that's all you get for this time, Nick. That's the wrong auto cue. It's the wrong auto cue. It's not the news auto cue. Due to have returned home with the 9th Battalion within the next 7 days. Can we just pedestal up a bit? Bring the pedestal up a little bit, please. I can't. That's better. Who's on lighting tonight? That key light is much too... Oh, can't even read. Anybody in there from news?
Cue.
Is there anybody in there from news? I just want to talk to somebody from the news department.
Come and get Brett Hall, please. Brett Hall! Where's Brett Hall? Brett Hall!
Right, just a little bit closer in. Bring it a little bit closer in.
Hey, you didn't put the disc on
the mic. How long to go? Could you give me a time cue, please?
3 minutes.
3 minutes, right. At Linfield this afternoon, a middle-aged woman was lucky to escape death when her car rolled over 3 times in a two-car collision.
Oops. No, we're not going to run.
Thank you.
Have a look at this demonstration. In my hand, for quickness, I've got a piece of nylon ribbon. Now, I know it's a synthetic, and I also know that I've got my eye on far hotter than I normally would have it. And for this reason, that I'm going to put this iron onto this piece of nylon, and as you can see here, I'm deliberately leaving it there, and I want the iron to get that hot on this bit of nylon that it will actually burn the nylon onto the iron itself. Now, when that does, you'll find that to try and get it... Oh! Jeez, I still mighty. What's going on here? I got a hell of a shock through that. Is there something wrong with your wiring? This is a 160cc Pace Victor mower. One of the finest in the world today. Why? It's got zip start. Now, with the throttle control at the back, just put it to start. Listen. And away she'll go after a couple of pulls, you rotten bastard. Now, if I keep quiet a moment, I want you to listen. You'll hear a slight pop. Hear that? Now, that'll give you an idea of exactly what happens. The gas has gone into the soda siphon, and obviously, I think we'll have to stop that again, because whether it was right or I don't know what the bloody hell happened. Down on this floor, there's lumps of dust, lumps of fluff, and sawdust. And yet, if I go right through the middle, you can actually see exactly where I've swept right the way through. Let's do the rest of it. You can follow me over here. You can see all these lumps and bumps, and you can even perhaps see all the dust that's coming up. We'll have to do that again, won't we? We've buggered that up finally. Yes, marvellous, isn't it? Right at the bloody death.
Hello, everyone. Here's wishing you a whole load of shit. Falling from a great height, all over you. All poop everywhere. Horse manure and vomit and stuff. Fighting your way through it as you're masturbating up there.
It's all a matter of taste. You're one of those people who honestly prefer the taste of Carlton Draft beer. So why don't you make Carlton Draft your take-home drink? Carlton Draft beer. The Victorian beer with a tradition of flavour, taste and deep-down satisfaction. You've got the taste for Carlton Draft beer. Don't lose it. Take it home in bottles and cans. Don't lose it. Take it home in bottles and cans.
Cameraman.
Sonny Icky, Sonny Icky, Sonny Ikigami.
All day long I'd sit upon my bum if I were a cameraman. Wouldn't have to work hard.
Sonny Icky, Sonny Icky, Sonny Ikigami.
Redheads, blondes would help to light my life if I were a cameraman. Zoom across the Robbie.
Sonny,
Icky,
Sonny,
Icky,
Sonny, Ikigami.
Philip with his talking robots, beauty world and travel, all right.
What are you doing, Mark? You told
us
that I'm
there. Get away from my back.
Sonny, Icky, Sonny, Icky, Sonny, Ikigami.
Go for in for Graham and the gang, or swanning it in center state.
If I were a cameraman, Sonny Icky, Sonny Icky, Sonny Ikigami. All day long I'd sit upon my bum, if I were a cameraman.
Have you had enough of sucking up to people for a living? Are you tired of copying abuse from everyone? Or are you just sick of being associated with news? Well, why not try being a tape operator? You get to work all sorts of unusual hours, not to mention weekends and public holidays, including Christmas Day. So how much would you expect to get paid for all this? But wait, there's more! You also get to watch commercials endlessly. Two lots of commercials at the same time. That's two lots of vision and two lots of audio, not to mention all the other background noise that you can hear. Who wants to work in sunshine and fresh air when you can be working in the on-air tape room? Cold in summer and boiling hot in winter. Too good to be true? Here's what some other tape operators have to say about their job.
I've been on graveyard shift for the last 2 weeks. It's the best night's sleep I've ever had.
For me, being a tape op is not a job, it's a way of life.
Being a tape op has really improved my social life. It's true, you know.
Becoming a tape operator was the best career move I ever made.
Some television stations have old equipment that never seems to work. Here at Wynn, we have the latest equipment with the most up-to-date technicians. How much do you think all this is worth? 100? 200? 300? Well, forget it. Because as well as all that, you get the honour of fixing up everyone else's mistakes. So once you've recorded all the day's commercials, you get to sit down and replace them with totally different ones. And as well as all that, even if you make the smallest mistake, you get your name put in a book, photocopied and passed around the station, so absolutely everyone gets to know about it.
Ring now, but don't send any money. That's right, do not send any money. We'll bill you. Ring 008-023-025, but don't send any money. Ring 008-023-025, but don't send any money. That's right, do not send any money. Ring now. Ring now, but don't send any money. That's right, do not send any money. We'll bill you. Ring 008-023-025, but don't send any money. Ring 008-023-025, but don't send any money. That's right, do not send any money. Ring now.
You're watching the ever-expanding Wynn News. Tragedy was narrowly averted on the weekend when a Wynn News crew covering the karting championships was cut down mid-race.
It was midway through the grueling kart classic when tragedy struck. A reckless kart driver, thought to be on a vendetta against Wynn Television, slammed into our trackside camera crew.
Jesus! Dion, are you all right?
Get out of it, Belly. Didn't get me in the balls.
A urine sample for police analysis is alleged to have had a blood alcohol content of 0.67, or 13 times the legal driving limit.
Oh, God. Yeah. Right, just give me time to dry my eyes and I shall be back to normal. Righto. Would you turn the monitor around? Oh, goodness.
He lay sleeping, what a shock, when his wife cut up his copperina bobby. She cut up his copperina bobby. She cut up his copper. Oh, Mrs. Bobbitt, will you really cut his copper tonight? She went driving down the street, out of the window and her husband's meat. Shopkeeper found that he was all I got, but it was a feeling to a hot dog. Now Mr. Bobbitt's had his fish on tight, become a celebrity overnight. All the women want the same thing, everywhere you can hear them sing. Mr. Bobbitt, please, show us you got. Mr. Bobbitt, please, show us you got. John Wayne Bobbitt, is your cock in your pocket tonight?
What the heck, let's check out
his double neck of bacon tonight.
You wouldn't realise the sort of coverage it gets in the national media Beef Week. Beef Week's a big date on the calendar. Very sorry we missed it here. There's one in Taree in New South Wales we try to catch. But this one here is the best one.
The best thing about Beef Week is when they open up the abattoirs and let the kiddies come down, have rides on the carcasses. That's always good fun. The one in Taree that we went to, the free show bags for the kids full of offal, that was fantastic. There's those nice little nuances that they have.
Also the parade as well, the wonderful parade where they have the Beef Queen as well, who goes on a float that travels down the main street here.
Yeah, Miss Beef Week, as we like to call her.
Potentially dangerous, yes.
What was it? What contacts was it inside it?
Ammonium nitrate.
And how is the dangerous of that? What happens to
it? Well, if you fucking drink the stuff, you're going to die. What do you think? How the hell do I know what ammonium nitrate's going to do? Do you know?
Okay. Yeah, just, what about the truck? Is it true the truck has got only a week old?
Well, it's not a week old, because it takes about 6 weeks to build a truck. And they don't pop out through a woman's fanny like you think they do. No, the truck is recently...
I saw you, you dirty bastard. You had her on the ground and you were trying to get into
a... No, I wasn't. I was just looking for my contact lens.
Is that what you call it nowadays? I bloody heard of some beauties, but that takes a cake. You were trying to help her. Fair and square, you little...
Look, I'm a red-blooded Aussie, and she's a real babe. Just what would you do if you were in my position?
Oh, Sebastian, I may come from Tasmania, but I've never done that with my daddy.
This sort of thing never happened back home.
Look, I don't care what you did back in Tassie. I love you, Vanessa.
There's no bloody way, boy. You're a bloody freak.
He must be, Daddy. You should see the size of it. It was so big I had to step over it.
Did you expose yourself to my darling little girl? Did you drop your pants, boy?
Oh, well, I'm out of here. See ya.
She doesn't, I will.
Okay, I'll think about it. But first I got to square things with Helen.
How are you going to achieve that miracle? Got something to show you if I can find it.
Ricky the Magic Pixie went to visit Daisy Bumble in her tumble-down cottage. He found her in the bedroom. Roughly, he grabbed her heavy shoulders, pulling her down onto the bed and ripping off her...
Hey!
Wow, that's good stuff, huh?
Don't read my book. You read your own book, okay?
Was it hard to live up to the image that everyone had put you up to in the papers and the public and everything like that?
Yeah, it is. It's very difficult.
In what respect?
What image?
Well, I'm in the image of Rod Stewart.
That's such dumb questions.
They aren't dumb questions. Will you bloody answer them to me?
Fucking hell.
What is it with Bowie that is so,
Charismatic.
No, what I'm just simply saying, John, is about time that...
Wear them well.
Oh, no!
Thanks for having us, Mole, you know.
Well, thank you, Shirley. And what's this boring sign?
Hey, that's you.
No, that's wrong. You're on... I think I'm dying on television. Where are we?
Molly Meldrum's house was broken into late this afternoon and his phrase book was stolen. Police are looking for a group of semiologists who got the address wrong. And in a legislative quantum leap, the Queensland National Party has decreed that all AIDS victims will retrospectively be classified as homosexuals and stoned to death under medical supervision.
When you came out to Australia, I thought afterwards, he's a little prick. I must say...
Well, you didn't see it.
Sorry?
You didn't see it.
We can't say that.
Good evening. Tonight, I want you...
What a rude person!
It's time to say goodbye now. I got a proposal of marriage to you.
On the sea, roly-poly, roly-poly, roll.
Perhaps you'd like to get somebody to help you, make a glass bottom boat, but preferably not anybody in the family because it's obscene and it's called incest.
Get out of there, Jemima, will you? Well, it's time for us to go now, but before we go, because it's the last day of school this week, let's shut the doors.
Do you ever do that? Lick?
I do that in this area as well. Wipe, wipe, wipe the blood. Mmm, duck biscuits. I never had a duck biscuit. I was deprived.
Oh, very good.
Ah! Oh, fuck.
Kerry and I have been having an affair on the side.
What side?
Ever since she burnt my house.
Which side?
Excuse us.
I'm just trying to work out what to do for the kids. Ross, can
what
you just
are they
stay
doing?
Up? Gorgeous.
Helen. Like the new camera, Eric?
Thank
Got
you.
It for a song, did you?
Maggots!
Oh! Oh, fuck! Just a wombat. Forgot my line. Chris Pot.
Hello there. Well, as far back as many can remember, well, January 1952 to be exact, Majestic Fanfare has been the ABC news theme. Now you know what it's called. And you've just seen an early television news title. But, as you know, television is only half as old as the ABC itself. Today, Artie has undone her straight laces just a little. So on this day, our 50th birthday, we'll start news again with the 1982 version of Majestic Fanfare.
Good evening, Richard Moorcroft with the Newcastle and Northern News for ABC Television. Newcastle people will be paying less for their gas from today. The Newcastle Gas Company has reduced its charges following the arrival of the natural gas pipeline from Sydney. From today, the surcharge on gas bills imposed during the pipeline's construction last year will be lifted, bringing gas prices back to the July 1981 level. A gas company spokesman said...
Hello, welcome
the move
to Sydney.
..would effectively reduce gas bills. I like it much better this way. It's a very friendly place. Very happy to be here. I'm very
just
happy...
Just continuing on with this news, a gas company spokesman said the move would effectively reduce gas bills by about 20%. This is Geraldine Judd continuing on with the... What is it? Newcastle News, is it?
Newcastle and Northern, yes.
Newcastle and Northern, that goes to them. Did he sound off road to the roof? Excuse me.
Would you, you actually want to see?
Yes,
look,
thank you.
Let me make room. Here we are, this is much more comfortable.
Power charges were still being discussed. Give me Power charges were still being discussed by the Shortland County Council up to a short time ago. The council's finance committee, they don't know anything anyway. Dear idea.
Coming up in the news tonight, the teachers' strike, a vote not to hold any more strike this year, and a school where I didn't go on strike. President Reagan disturbed hard-line Republican with appointment of his new White House expert on foreign policy. Immediately orders a review of U.S. policy in the Middle East.
A naughty weather forecast. I'd just been up on the roof and it pissing down with rain.
The Australian Broadcasting Corporation is to phase out its regional television stations at Rockhampton and Townsville in Queensland. The chairman of the ABC, Mr. Meyer, said today the corporation had made it clear that it couldn't afford to maintain television studios in regional areas and that television policy provided for a national and state structure.
Oh, God. He's terribly tedious, isn't he? Thanks, Richard.
Now, just before we go, Yes, we do know that Townsville is further north than Rockhampton. Apologies for this mistake on our map a little bit earlier, and many thanks to those people who rang in. That's all the news for now. I'll be back with the late news around about 10:15, but now let's hear from Geraldine.
He's trying not to smile, Richard. Yes, well...
Also tonight, negative iron generators. Many offices have one, but a scientific study says there's no evidence they promote good health and well-being.
As well, the Klaus von Bülow trial... Oh, shit, what is the matter with this?
It must be the lack of a negative iron generator.
Sorry. I'd rather be sort of one of those sporting people who have hips that go slightly like this and who enjoy the sight of blood on the field. He's coming down, he's grabbed the ball. My God, that's a fantastic tackle. Oh, I enjoyed that.
Pretty boring.
Now, other news in brief from around the country. The Northern Territory opposition leader Bob Collins has resigned to stand for the Senate at the next election.
And now, the political commentator. I can actually only see one point of view, and it's mine. Goodbye.